Pleased to see you today.
Gran placer verlo hoy. Usted y yo nos vamos a sentar por algunos momentos aquí. Después vendrán tres oleadas de fotos. Y después iremos al Salón del Consejo de Ministros. Es el almirante Poindexter.
Ah, el presidente. Good to see you. Nice to see you.
Some of our press will try to ask questions. I'll try to tell them what I'm going to answer. The third wave would be your photographers. Your
photographers.
Oh, cool.
That's great.
How are you today?
I'm very
good. Esperamos solo por los fotógrafos.
So we're going to wait here for the photographers?
Yes, they're
here. Sí, ahora están por llegar los primeros.
USAID in the event of aggression against his country?
We haven't entered our discussions yet, so we'll have a statement after we've met.
Lights, please. Thank you. This way.
Okay,
thank you. This way, please. Yeah. Lights, please. Thank you.
Afterward, I found out. You'll be down this side.
Ustedes estarán en el Prime Minister, Mr.
Nice to see you.
General Regalado, Fifth Avenue.
Nice to see you.
You know best for
President, honor to see you.
See you. Sitting and smiling for the press for a few minutes.
Yeah.
We can start talking.
Yes.
Mr. President, we value very highly, I'm sure you know, your cooperation and friendship and democratic example. And, I am most interested in hearing your view of, well, not only our bilateral relationship, but of the situation in the region, Central America, that I know we're both concerned about. So I would appreciate your assessment.
Con mucho gusto, señor presidente. Queremos decirle con mucha satisfacción.
We would like to tell you with a great deal of satisfaction that in Honduras,
afortunadamente, la política exterior de nuestro gobierno,
foreign policy of our government,
está siendo apoyada por
is being supported.
Si usted tiene algún punto que cree que quedó un poco,
do you think there were any points that
poco discutido,
were not discussed sufficiently?
Agradeceríamos que nos lo haga saber.
I'd be grateful if you would mention whatever point you would like to have discussed further.
Oh dear. Well, no. Look,
putting down my rent.
That's the Secretary of Treasury. We haven't heard from him today.
Well, I would, Mr. President, simply add to what we said in the cabinet room that we are very pleased with your economic program, particularly the fiscal and monetary parts. We're somewhat concerned.
It's been my honor to welcome to Washington and to confer with President Escona of Honduras. We've had extremely useful discussions today. We both expressed our appreciation for the positive and solid relationship that our two countries enjoy. We reviewed recent developments in Central America, including the summit meeting this past weekend. President Escona and I are in full agreement on the necessity of working for greater economic growth in Central America and the importance of democratic institutions to the cause of peace in the region. I reaffirm the commitment of the United States to cooperate closely with Honduras, both in helping to build its economy and in bolstering its democracy. I express to President Escona my personal thanks and that of the American people for his government's responsible stand on regional issues. Our two governments share a serious concern over the threat to peace, stability, and freedom posed by the communist regime in Nicaragua. The Nicaraguan communists, with extensive Soviet and Cuban support, persist in repressing their own population and in backing the subversion of their democratic neighbors. This endangers all of Latin America and ultimately the United States as well. In this regard, I underscored to the President our promise to stand by Honduras in defense of its national sovereignty and territorial integrity, as is in accordance with our reciprocal international rights and obligations. A joint communique will be issued today reiterating this mutual commitment. President Escona and I agree that our countries and the other democracies in the region must act together to end the conflict that plagues Central America. But it's not just up to us. Securing regional peace will require an end to communist aggression, as well as national reconciliation and democratization within Nicaragua. Honduras has been diligent and persistent in its pursuit of a comprehensive and verifiable solution within the framework of the Contadora negotiations. Mr. President, you have our support in these efforts. The United States continues to believe that a realistic and enforceable agreement based on the full implementation of the Contadora Document of Objectives is one way to bring peace to Central America. And finally, it was a great personal pleasure to meet President Escona. I look forward to continuing our work in the same spirit of friendship and respect that was so evident in our meeting today. So, Mr. President, we thank you for coming. Godspeed on your way home.
Ha sido muy grato conversar con el presidente Reagan. Considero que estos cambios de impresiones, realizados en un ambiente de amplia cordialidad y franqueza, resultan siempre provechosos, pues derivan en una mejor comprensión y en un mayor entendimiento entre nuestros pueblos y gobiernos.
It has been a great pleasure to talk with President Reagan. I believe that these exchanges of views, held in a climate of great cordiality and frankness, are always beneficial because they lead to greater understanding and a better relationship between our governments and peoples.
Con el presidente Reagan hemos pasado revista a los distintos aspectos de las armoniosas relaciones bilaterales entre nuestros dos países y me complace expresar que en lo que al campo económico se refiere, encontré receptividad de su parte respecto a los planteamientos que le formulé.
por lo que confío en que su gran país apoyará con amplitud las acciones de mi gobierno tendientes a reactivar la economía hondureña y reducir las altas tasas de desempleo actualmente prevalecientes a fin de complementar los esfuerzos hondureños de corto y mediano plazo sin descuidar nuestras necesidades de seguridad.
With President Reagan, we have reviewed the various aspects of the harmonious bilateral relations between our two countries. I am happy to say that in the economic field, he was receptive to the points I made to him, so I am certain that his great country will give broad support to the measures which my government is taking to reactivate the Honduran economy and reduce our present high unemployment levels as a complement to Honduran short and medium-term efforts, all without neglecting our security needs.
He informado al presidente Reagan de los esfuerzos que nacionalmente estamos llevando a cabo para desarrollar mi país. En este contexto, le he reafirmado que el gobierno de Honduras atribuye a la inversión extranjera un papel de primer orden, pero reconoce que debido a la situación prevaleciente en Centroamérica, se necesita también la participación gubernamental y la cooperación de los gobiernos amigos, entre los cuales los Estados Unidos es uno de los más cercanos.
I have told President Reagan about the efforts we are making in Honduras to develop our country. In this context, I reiterated the fact that our government assigns the highest priority to foreign investment, while at the same time recognizing that at present we also require the participation of government and the cooperation of friendly countries, among which the United States is one of the closest.
Porque creo en la necesidad de ofrecer al inversionista extranjero un clima de tranquilidad que propicie su participación en el esfuerzo de los hondureños por desarrollar nuestro país y las garantías que le aseguren la protección de sus legítimos derechos, he autorizado al señor ministro de Relaciones Exteriores de Honduras para que en el curso de esta visita suscriba el convenio sobre arreglos de diferencias relativas a inversiones entre estados y nacionales de otros estados.
Because of the fact that we believe in the necessity of offering the foreign investor a climate of tranquility, encouraging his participation in the effort being made by Hondurans to develop our country, and of offering him guarantees which ensure the protection of his legitimate rights, I have authorized the foreign minister to sign, during this visit, the Treaty on the Settlement of Investment Disputes between states and nationals of other states.
Este convenio proveerá al inversionista extranjero en Honduras acceso a mecanismos legales internacionales de reconocida imparcialidad y competencia, que aunados a los que ofrece la legislación nacional, han de garantizarle el pleno goce de sus derechos.
This treaty will provide the foreign investor in Honduras with access to international legal mechanisms of recognized impartiality and competence, which together with those offered by Honduran law will guarantee to him the full enjoyment of his rights.
En el aspecto político, reiteramos nuestra identificación con los regímenes de derecho, basados en el ejercicio efectivo de la democracia y en el respeto de los derechos humanos.
In the political field, we reaffirmed our identity as a regime governed by the rule of law and based on the effective exercise of democracy and on respect for human rights.
Al examinar la situación centroamericana, comprobamos con preocupación que persisten en el área condiciones que perturban la seguridad y la paz. Estuvimos de acuerdo en que hay que realizar nuevos y grandes esfuerzos para encontrar una salida negociada a la crisis, fundamentada en acciones concretas de reconciliación nacional, en procesos electorales libres y honestos, en el desarme y, en general, en la creación de un ambiente donde la libertad y la seguridad para todos garanticen el desarrollo económico y social de los pueblos centroamericanos. Para ello, es necesario llegar a acuerdos jurídicos y plenamente verificables entre los estados centroamericanos.
When we examined the situation in Central America, we noted with concern that conditions jeopardizing peace and security still exist. We agreed that major new efforts must be made to find a negotiated solution to the crisis, based on concrete actions for national reconciliation, on free and honest elections, on disarmament, and in general on the creation of a climate in which freedom and security for all can guarantee the economic and social development of the peoples of Central America. To that end, it is necessary to conclude fully verifiable juridical arrangements among the Central American states.
El presidente Reagan me reiteró que mientras persistan graves amenazas a la seguridad de Honduras y a la estabilidad de nuestras instituciones democráticas en aplicación de la relación especial de seguridad que existe entre nuestros países, el gobierno de los Estados Unidos, en caso de una agresión armada contra Honduras, estará listo a prestarle la ayuda necesaria que el gobierno hondureño le solicite.
President Reagan reiterated to me that in accordance with the special security relationship which exists between our two countries, as long as grave threats to Honduras' security and to the stability of our institutions persist, the government of the United States will be prepared, in the case of armed aggression against Honduras, to render it any necessary assistance which the Honduran government may request.
Finalmente, expreso mi satisfacción porque en el curso de esta visita, las relaciones de amistad y de cooperación que existen entre Honduras y los Estados Unidos se han revigorizado en un marco de lealtad y respeto mutuo. Muchas gracias.
Finally, I would like to say how very gratified I am that in the course of this visit, the relations of friendship and cooperation which exist between Honduras and the United States have been strengthened within a framework of trust and mutual respect. Thank you very much.